what it is, what's happening. Well, as you can tell, I'm laying on the ground, well, on a creeper. And I'm pulling the trans in the 84 wrecker, the one with the Hums 1200 Commander body on it. Well, we lost the clutch. And it looks like, I'm thinking the throwout bearing is actually our failure. But of course we're gonna put a whole clutch in it. We're not just gonna patch it up. Even though this truck doesn't see the road anymore, this truck gets used a lot. So we're just about ready to pull the trans. I gotta take this speedometer cable transducer off because the speedometer cable, of course, it's stuck in there. It's always one thing after the other. I'll tell you, when you work on your own junk, it's just something. So we are loose. We're ready to pull this trans. Now I like to work in profanity, so you might wanna curve your ears or take little children out of the room. Because I tend to work with the band. Got me something fucking behind me now. I had to cut all the bolts to hold this crossmember in. I had to cut every last one of them out because they were just rotten. Now, what I don't like about these old square body Chevys is, I don't know if you can see it up in there. Let me see if I can get you. The trans on these damn things sticks way up, and the floor doesn't have a trans tunnel that's removable like on a Ford. That I've always hated with these trucks. Just make pulling a transmission so much fun for the entire family. And you know, working on the ground is just the most enjoyable thing there is in the entire world. I just enjoy it so much. Especially when a transmission weighs more than me. You gotta get a pry bar. You know, it's always something. You gotta get another tool. Have half the toolbox under here and it's still not enough. I just enjoy this work so much. We're stuck on the floor. I don't know what that was. That was a bolt. To what? I don't know. Alright. So now we're hung up. I'm up in the trans tunnel there. There we go. This is what separates the boys from the men. Probably doesn't help that the motor doesn't lean back enough because, as you can see, I've got true dual exhaust on it that I put on it about 4 or 5 years ago. Oh, that's a little too far for my liking. One good Harbor Freight ratchet strap. She's hanging in there for dear life. Alright, we're out. Get this thing down so that I can reposition that later. Because I don't like that. So, let's see what we got, boys and girls. I believe I was correct in my diagnosis. I'm trying to bring you guys along as I work on the old girl. But looks like that's where our failure was. Thaw bearing just came apart. I mean, just come apart. Well, let's zip this bell housing off and see what else we find. Let's get some light on the subject. Oh yeah, you can see all the fingers are tore up in there. All right, let's, Now this thing here, I'm gonna get rid of. This was original throttle up cable. So this runs to the back of the truck and you would pull it to idle it up, but I've since put electric solenoid on. So I'm gonna get rid of this thing, make that go away because that's super annoying in my way to work on this toilet. And you know, sad part is I really need this truck in the worst way. Got so much work to do around here. And this truck just makes my life so much easier. We gotta put the, we're ready to set the bed back on the J10, but we can't without a truck because there's no way I can pick that thing up. But, you know, something's always gonna be a pain. Come on. Of course, I'm working on the transmission. Stupid fucking camera thingy. Come on, bitch. I hate this thing. This thing weighs about 900 tons. Let me move you guys out of the way for a hot minute because I'm having issues here. Maybe you guys can see back here what I'm doing. I'm not quite sure. I'm trying to work around you guys. Nice to have a film crew, but I'm a one-man wrecking crew. Now, get this out of the way because we put that in the parts washer, I'm sure. You know, I don't think I've done a clutch in a Chevrolet like this in 20 years. Today I bought a 12 inch clutch. This turd could either be 11 or 12. I went with 12 because, well, normal thinking would say it's a tow truck, it's gotta be, but you never know. We're just going to, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, we we are gonna biscuit the flywheel and put this bitch right back together. So let's go see if we got the right parts and let's take a look what we got. All right, let me drag all this trash out of here.
Yep. We got it out. So it is a 12-inch clutch. I just checked it. So we're good. We actually called for 11 or 12 in this turd. But that's what failed. Thaw bearing just came apart. And it actually damaged our clutch fork, which I may just repair it. Put a groove in it. You can see. So the thing I'm gonna do is get it out of there. You can see I put a groove in it right there and there. I think what I'm gonna do is I think I'm just gonna clean this all up. I'm just gonna weld it and just grind it. I think is what I'm gonna do with it. I think that's how I'm gonna fix it. After all, this truck doesn't see the road. This truck just sees the yard. That probably doesn't even go over 10 mile an hour. Probably never even get it in second gear, honestly. Probably in the last 6 years. Just kind of idles around the yard, moving stuff, picking stuff up. But the disc is shot. I mean, it's, you can see it's really worn. But, I mean, realistically, I probably could put it back together and just put a bearing in it, but I'm not going to. A whole brand new clutch kit from Napa was, what the hell's this? This is part of the bearing. Trying to figure out how it all goes together, how it all came apart. Okay, so I guess this would have been, your bearing would have been in here. So there we go. That's what it was. And it just literally disintegrated itself. And I knew something happened because when I pushed the clutch in, the pedal went to the floor. But right before the pedal went to the floor, the pedal was jumping real hard, which, if you got any mechanical knowledge, you would know that more than likely, and the funny thing was, it didn't make any noise. The bearing just literally went. It didn't, wasn't making any squealing noises or nothing. But when the pedal started jumping, I knew something was wrong. What it was doing was it was jumping on those fingers. So it was done. New pressure plate, new disc, new bearing, and clean it all up, and we'll put it back together tomorrow. I want to wash this fork so I can weld that up, clean it up, and I'm going to go ahead and throw this bell housing in the parts washer and just kind of give it a quick scrub. But we're all apart. That wore me out for the evening. See, what else do you guys do on a Friday evening? I know what I'm doing. Putting a clutch in that. Yay. But I desperately need the truck, desperately, desperately. I got a Jeep truck out back that I sold some parts off of. I need to pick it up. Yeah, 12 tow trucks here, and I don't have nothing to pick it up with. But what's nice about this truck is, because it's a hydraulic truck, it's a 1200, the boom extends, and I use it like a crane. That's what's really nice about this truck. All the other trucks are fully mechanical. What I mean by fully mechanical is they're mechanical driven cable winches. This truck, it's kind of hard to see at nighttime. This truck, the boom comes out real far, and I use it as a crane. Sorry for bouncing you guys around. But I use it as a crane to pick things up, put things down. I got to burn the rear out of a truck, and I want to get the bed back on the J10, which is now the J20 Jeep project that I've been fooling with, and that bed's extremely heavy. I'll use a wrecker. And I got a bunch of other stuff I'm doing that I need the truck for. If you saw the new to me 52 Chevy wrecker that I just bought, I'm going to look at a bed in the next week or so. if I buy that bed, I'm gonna need a way to get it off the trailer when I get home. In theory, I should be able to wrap this thing up tomorrow morning and it'll be fixed. That's if the trans don't fall off the jack. It's got one Harbor Freight strap holding on. I might put another one on there. So I'm gonna wrap it up here for this evening on the video, because do you really wanna watch me wash parts in the parts washer? Besides, there's really bad music on the radio. Holla at your boy, keep it real.